I'm Reverend Derek Moody, your minister of complete madness. And it is time now, brothers and sisters, for a Gary Richrath exclusive telephone interview. I'm not going to do Church of Rock and Roll music news tonight because Gary is from East Peoria. He was in REO Speedwagon. They sold millions of records, and I thought it'd be fun to throw an interview on just for those of you knowing the past of rock and roll in Central Illinois. Kind of the homegrown spotlight part two is what it is. And I'm going to go ahead and roll it now because they have had enough talking. It's Gary Richrath, exclusive interview only on Real Rock Radio, Rock 106. Anyway, I've got on the line with me right now ex-REO Speedwagon guitar player Gary Richrath, who, of course, is an East Peoria native, right, Gary?
Yeah, absolutely. Yeah, I'm back home again.
Yeah, how long are you in town for, man?
I'm the state, all in all, is 9 days. Actually, I came back for two things. I came back for my son, Eric. And Jen, his wife, wedding. They got married on Saturday, and it was a total blast.
Well, congratulations. You got a new daughter-in-law.
Yeah, man. Really. And and also I came back to see my mom. I'm at my mom's house now. And relatives. I have that. I think I'm related to half of East Peoria and Peoria. So.
I think so. I know you still got a lot of fans in this area.
Yeah, that's true. I went and played at my ex-wife's club, JJ something or other, and it was like packed, and I had a great time there too.
And that's over at the Metro Center, right?
Yeah, exactly.
JJ Ryan's, I believe.
Yeah, I brought down Marshall and Les Paul, and it happened.
You know what happened? One of our listeners, actually, Ron McFall,
he
called up from a cell phone while you were on stage, and we had it on the air.
Oh, you had it on the air. Well, yeah. That's good.
And actually, and the part we did hear sounded really good.
Yeah, no, the band I was sitting in was excellent. So I had a great time playing, and we played until my ears.
Now, I'll tell you what, for a lot of the listeners that are younger, maybe, when did REO Speedwagon first form?
I joined the band in 1970, and they've been together prior to that for like a couple. Alan and Alan Gratzer and Neil Dowdy actually started the band in probably 68.
Really?
Yeah, they were doing like frat parties and stuff like that. But when I joined them in 1970, they weren't doing any original material then, so I brought in some original songs and stuff, and we got a record deal pretty much right off the bat.
Now, what was the first hit song REO had?
That took about 7 years.
Really?
Yeah. Our first gold album was gold and platinum album. Was the live album You Get What You Play For.
No, what a killer record that is.
And Ride the Storm out was came out in 1973, I believe. But the version I like is on the live album.
Yeah, that's an awesome record, man.
Yeah, thank you.
So how many records did you actually make with REO?
Oh, my gosh. you know, there's so many. We did it for like foreign releases and stuff. I'd say all full. Around 20, I believe. You know, it was kind of there were the statewide ones, and there were some just released in Europe and stuff.
Right.
We made a few.
So how many of them went gold or platinum or whatever?
Pretty much all of them.
Wow. That's quite a good success story there, man.
Yeah.
And the big question, of course, you know I'm going to ask you.
Sure.
Is when and why did you leave REO Speedwagon? Because a lot of people tend to have different stories about why you're not in that band.
Yeah, well, I've heard a lot of stories too about that. It was just come to the point where Kevin and I were having musical differences and this, that, and the other, and it was I was ready for a change, and Kevin was ready for a change, and I thought he was actually going to go out solo and stuff, which he ended up not doing and stuff. So I was looking forward to it, which I still am. I am in the process of finding the right people. The right combination of people, and I'm gonna be playing again. I can't wait.
So basically, the bottom line is you two didn't get along any longer, and that was it.
Yeah, but we're still friends and stuff, and we do get along. It's just musically, he wanted to go in one direction, and I wanted to go in another direction, and
so correct.
He wanted to have more of his songs on the album, and I wanted to keep it 50-50 like it always has been.
Now, one thing I did hear, tell me if this is true, if you would. He wanted to do more ballads, and you wanted to rock more. Is that true?
I've heard that from a few people, including myself. Yeah.
Yeah. Okay.
I wanted to rock more, and he was. He just wanted to go in another direction. So
are you still in touch with those guys at all?
Yeah. In fact, we're doing something or other. I I'm meeting with them in the next couple of weeks. We're doing, like, I believe, that VH1 behind the scenes thing.
Oh, really? That'll be interesting.
Yeah.
Now, is VH1 coming to Central Illinois to talk to anybody here?
I have no idea. You know, I live in Los Angeles, even though this still feels like home to me.
Yeah.
And that's where we're doing it out there. So,
wow.
I kind of doubt if they're coming through because there's not going to be anything out here, but I'm not sure.
Well, I just hope they get the story accurate, but I'm sure.
Well, you know what? I only speak the truth.
That's good, man.
It'll be accurate.
So what are you doing now? We know you live in California. Right. Do you still have your ranch?
No. Right now I'm in the transition process. I just got married 2 months ago.
Well, congratulations, Gary.
Thank you. And a couple months in November 22nd, actually.
Ah.
And so we're in a transition period. I'm living. We have it's like a townhouse. I'm doing demos and looking for people. I'm looking for singers, basically.
So basically, when you get a singer, there's a chance we could see Gary Richrath out rocking again.
Yeah, well, there's not only a chance it's going to be, or else I'm going to all go crazy.
Well, I'm a singer, don't you, Gary?
Oh, you are?
Yes, I am.
Right. Hey, you know, I'm ready for an audition if you want to.
Well, I'd love to come and audition for you, man.
All right.
Another Peoria native.
All right, good. So keep the word out, but my main consideration right now.
Well, I tell you what, no sissy ballads for me, man.
All right. Okay, now I didn't say that, you did.
That's right. I only speak the truth.
Yeah, as long as you can still rock.
So what are your favorite REO tunes? I know it's kind of a lame question, but I'm curious, what is one of your favorite REO songs?
Well, Tango's Run, Riding the Storm Out obviously did well for me. There's like hidden things, not hidden things, but songs that got overlooked that really like kind of like broke my heart. There's a song called Lightning that I really, really love.
You know what, Gary? I just downloaded that song off Napster, I swear to God.
Really?
Yeah.
Cool. Well, that song was always one of my favorites, and it just kind of like paints the picture. Very visual. I was living in Champaign when I wrote that, and there was a lightning, a thunderstorm came through and knocked out all the power in the house, and I was living on a farm then down there.
Wow.
So I lit a candle and wrote the song.
That's awesome, man.
Thank you.
You know, the first time I ever saw you perform, it was about 78. And you guys were playing at the Bradley Auditorium.
Yeah, I remember that show.
Yeah, it was pretty cool. That was one of my first concerts. I'm showing my age, obviously.
That's okay.
But it was cool, man. I really had a good time. And to be talking to you all these years later, it makes me happier than hell.
Okay.
And it's nice talking to you, man.
It's a nice talking to you. And believe me, I'll be out playing again now. And I'm doing some dealings with the European label now. And I'm in the process of that. And then the States, I think. So I'll get a band back together. You know, you keep your cheeks, keep your singing chops up, too.
I'll try to do that, and I'll try to get a hold of you, man.
All right.
And we appreciate you talking to us here at Rock 106, man.
My pleasure.
Thanks, Gary.
You bet.
All right. Gary Richrath, ex-REO Speedwagon. It's a Rock 106 exclusive.